Hello everyone, DonOHD here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up, configure, and install Teknoparrot games on Launchbox. I have my arcade folder here, and located inside I have my Launchbox folder, my ROMs folder where we're going to be keeping our ROMs, and the emulators folder where we're going to be extracting our emulator to. You're going to need to go to Teknoparrot.com and download the emulator. When you visit the website, you're going to click here on download. And then you're going to click on this version right here, Download TB Bootstrapper Web Installer for Teknoparrot. I'm going to download this to my desktop because I'm going to be installing it to my emulators folder. I have the program on my desktop, and this program actually has to be extracted and then installed. So I'm going to open it up, and I'm going to drag the contents to my desktop here. And I'm going to direct it to my emulators folder. So over here on my emulators folder, I'm going to create a Teknoparrot folder. Select where you'd like to download Teknoparrot to. I'm going to click Browse. Select my desktop, Arcade, Emulators, Teknoparrot. Wherever you have yours located, you direct yours to that directory. In my case, I'm using the desktop. Select Full Install. And it's going to take a few seconds for it to download everything, depending on your internet connection. You're going to see this screen. Seems like this is the first time you're running Teknoparrot UI. Please set emulation settings. Click OK. It says you have no game set up. Do you want to add one now? You can say yes. I'm going to select Star Wars Battle Pod. I'm going to click Add Game. I'm going to click Game Settings. And it's looking for the rslauncher.exe file. So I'm going to direct it to where it is. It's in my ROMs folder, Teknoparrot, Star Wars Battle Pod. And there it is, rslauncher.exe. Now that I've selected that, you can configure some of the settings here. I'm using my arcade controls, so I'm going to select Use Keyboard Button for Access, and I think that's all I need right now, so I'm going to go to Save Settings. Now I'm going to go to Controller Setup, and here I'm going to configure my controls. This is how I set mine. You can set yours however you feel like you need to. I'm going to click Save Settings. I'm going to click on these three lines here at the top left corner, and I'm going to click Install Updates, and whatever you need, you click Update. If you're done with your updates, you can click Return to Library. You need to run each game once so the user's profile file can be in the Teknoparrot folder when it comes time for us to insert it in Launchbox. So I'm going to run Star Wars Battle Pod. I'm going to close this program. You don't need these files anymore on the desktop. You can delete those now. And now it's time to set up Teknoparrot in Launchbox. Okay, now we're here in Launchbox, and now we need to set up the emulator. So what we're gonna do is click on the top three lines here at the top left corner. We're gonna click Tools, Manage, Emulators. We're gonna click Add. The emulator name is Teknoparrot. Set your path. Mine is on my desktop, Arcade, Emulators, Teknoparrot, and click on the exe here. Now you go to associated platforms and you name the platform you want to put it on. In my case, I'm typing in Sega Ring Edge. Make sure that the box is checked that it's the default emulator. I've also included a link in the description below for a script that if you require it, you can escape out of the game by pressing the escape key. I'm going to go here and I'm going to paste that here now. Now I'm going to click OK. And I'm going to close. And now it's time to install the games. We're going to go to Tools, Import, ROM Files, Next, Add Files. It's in the Emulators folder, the Teknoparrot folder, User Profiles, and here's the ROM name. Next, the platform that I've been porting for is Sega Ring Edge. I'm going to scrape it as an arcade. I'm going to click Next. The emulator is Teknoparrot. Next. Use files in my current location. Next. Images. Next. 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 And then you need to name your ROM correctly so the metadata can search for the correct images. And now I'm going to click Finish. And now it is installing the game. Alright, we have one last step. Now what we're going to do here is going to right click on the game. We're going to click Edit. Edit Metadata Media. We're going to go to the Launching tab. And we're going to copy this end extension here. StarWars.xml. We're going to copy that. Then we're going to go to the Emulation tab. And you're going to check this box right here that says Use Custom Line Parameters. And then you're going to type in two dashes, profile, the equal sign, and the XM file that we just pasted. Once you've done that, you click OK. And then now you can run your game. And here's a little bit of Star Wars Battlepod gameplay. I recommend that you disable the startup screen for the big box platform so you don't have the full screen issue that I had. And here's a little bit of Luigi's Mansion arcade gameplay. And we've come to the end of our video. Thank you for watching the video. If this video helped you out at all, please drop a like and subscribe. I've created more tutorials for other emulators as well. You can click on the videos on the screen. As always, I'm DonLHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.